Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easter Seals Crossroads. And today we're going to be talking about slow keys for Mac. So let's go ahead and take a look.
So today we're going to take a look at an accessibility feature called slow keys on the MacBook computer. On your screen, we've got a Microsoft Word document open. I've also got Photo Booth connected to my iPhone, taking a look at my keyboard, because this is a keyboard accessibility feature. And so what it is helpful for is it helps you keep from putting repeated keystrokes into the places where you're typing. And this can be a real challenge for folks who may have dexterity or fine motor control issues in their fingers. It might also be an issue for folks who have to lean on the keyboard or get close to the keyboard and they accidentally press a key they didn't mean to press, and that's creating extra work for them to be able to edit their document after the fact. And so what I want to do is I'm going to first off bring up the accessibility menu. So I'm going to go down to my settings. We're going to open that up and we're going to go into accessibility. And I'm going to show you where you can find this feature. So in accessibility, you've got some different categories. You've got vision, you've got hearing. And then down here, the third section is called motor. Under motor, there is a keyboard. We're going to click on the keyboard, and that's going to bring us to where slow keys is going to be located. And it gives a definition here about what slow keys will do for you. It says slow keys adjust the amount of time between when a key is pressed and when it is activated. And that delay is what's going to help folks from putting in repeated keystrokes in the places that they go to type. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn it on, and it's going to give you a notification that it's on. And next, I'm going to click on the eye next to the feature, and we're just going to look inside here. Two things that it gives you. It gives you the option for making a click sound when you click a keystroke. So maybe you're leaning on a key and you didn't even notice that you're leaning on it. This is going to actually, every time you press a key, it's going to give you kind of like that old typewriter sound when you click a key and it goes ahead and types that key on that key or letter symbol onto your document. The other thing that you can do is you can adjust the delay, and I'm going to leave it long, the longest delay we can, just for the purposes of our video today. Depending on the individual that you work with or yourself, whatever your needs are, you can adjust that up and down to be a very short delay or a long delay. It can be really helpful for folks. We'll click OK, and then we will get out of our accessibility menu. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my cursor over here in my document, and I'm just going to go ahead and type my name. I'm going to hit the shift key. Notice you could hear that sound, and I'm going to hit the letter B. And I'm going to go ahead and press that shift key again, because I didn't press it long enough. Notice if I just press something really quickly, it doesn't do anything for me. And that's because I've increased the delay. I've actually got to hold the key down in order for it to press and actually put the key into my document. So I'm going to press my space bar and just hold it down a second. And it's going to go ahead and press it for me. Now I'm going to press my shift key. And you can hear that little trigger that it's actually been pressed. Then I'll press my B key and hold it down. And then I'll do, so it really keeps me from doing repeated keystrokes because it's making me delay just a moment before the key's actually put into my document. And so it can be really helpful for those folks who, again, have limited dexterity, fine motor control, just the inability to be able to kind of get their fingers up and off the keys in an appropriate time period. And what's happening, if you can't, is it's putting in multiple keystrokes into your document, again, creating some editing issues, especially if you have difficulty already using the keyboard. Well, I hope this is helpful. Again, that's slow keys, and it's a part of the accessibility settings on your MacBook.
That's your tech tip for today. I want to say thank you to the Indiana Telephone Relay Access Corporation for sponsoring our captions today. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.